Hello friends, welcome back to our channel Technology. So today in this video tutorial, I will show you guys how to install Windows operating system or any other operating system like Linux operating system using network. So that means you can install our OS using your network. So if you have a multiple PC on your local area network and if you want to install our operating system together, then this video is for you. So now I'm going to be talking about the benefits for network OS installation. Number one is it saves system administrator time in deploying the operating system. That's mean it will not take that much of time to install any operating system. Number two is reduce the complexity and the cost. That means you don't need to buy a multiple DVD or pen drive to install the OS one by one all the computers. So now I'm going to be talking about the methods. So there are lots of methods available on the internet. But if you don't have a proper knowledge about Windows Server, WDS like Windows Deployment Service or Red Hat Linux Server, then you cannot do it properly. So I will show you guys the simple methods by which you can install an operating system using your network. So now I'm going to be talking about the installation requirement. So number one is you need an operating system ISO file like Windows 7 or Windows 10 or any Linux ISO file. So if you don't have any ISO file or if you don't know how to download the ISO file, then I have already made a video on this topic. So I will give you the links on my video description. So number two is make sure that you have multiple operating system on your network, minimum two or more than that. So if you don't have a multiple PC and if you want to test this method, then you can use virtual machine like VMware or VirtualBox. Number three is make sure that all the system are connected through your router. Number four is make sure that your router have a DHCP server. Also, you can check out my other videos like how to install a Windows operating system or Linux operating system without any CVD, DVD or pen drive. So I will give you all the links on my video description. You can check out from there. So now let's start the video. So at first you need to go to your My Computer and you have to make one blank partition. Okay, so for that you need to just right click on this PC. So if you are using Windows 7 computer or 8 computer, you will get a My Computer over there. So you have to click on right click over there and click on manage. Okay, after that you will get this computer management window. So you have to go to this disk management tab, and now I'm going to shrink one volume from this drive, the games drive, which is 207 GB is free. Okay, so just open computer management tool and let me find my game drive. So here is my game drive. So games drive, here is the game drive. So I will just shrink some volume from here. Okay, so I will sync 72 GB. okay, now click on sync. So as you can see, one unallocated partition is created automatically over there. So right click on that unallocated partition and click on new simple volume, and after that click on next and click on next and then next, then finish. Okay, so after that go to your My Computer and you can see your new blank partition over there. So in my case it is 70 GB. You can choose near about 10 to 20 GB, it's depend upon you. Okay, so after create a blank partition, okay, just go to your My Computer and right click on that volume and just go to the properties, and after that click on sharing. Okay, and now click on advanced sharing, and you have to check this option which is share this folder. After that go to the permission tab and select the everyone from here and give the full control to this drive. Okay, after that click on apply, then okay, then apply, then okay, then close. Okay, so before let me go once again on sharing option. So before close this tab, you have to copy this network path on your notepad. So just open the notepad on your computer and just paste this network path. Okay, after that just minimize this, all those things. So after that you have to go to this website which is Aio Boot, all-in-one bootable software. So after go to this website, you have to click on this download button,
and now click on Aio Boot Extractor.exe. So I will give you this downloading on my video description. So after that, you have to click on this download button, or you can click on here. Okay. So as you can see, it's downloading. So you have to wait for a few seconds. So after download, copy the boot extractor file, this AI extractor file, on your new partition, which is J drive in my case. Okay, I have pasted under this drive. As you can see, it is the AI boot extractor. So now what you have to do, you need to download one Windows 7 or 10 ISO file and copy paste on your J drive new partition. Okay. So in my case, it is J drive. So as you can see, here is the two file. So after copy both the file over there, you have to open the AIO boot extractor. So just double click over there, or you can use right click over there and click on open. Okay, after that you will get this window. So if you want to change your language, then click on this right side corner tab, lang, and after that select here English. Okay, now what you have to do, from here you have to select your hard drive. In my case, it is J. So now you have to select here, check this option, which is use hard disk drive. Okay, now you have to select this option drop down menu, and you can get over there your partition. In my case, it is J, as you can see. So now you have to click on this OK button over there, and it will take some time. So as you can see, it's done. It is done, as you can see. So now go to the integration on this AIO boot creator. Okay, after that click on the select pack, and here into select Windows, and if you want to install Linux OS, then you have to select here Linux OS. In my case, I am using Windows 10 operating system I am trying to install. So I will select here Windows, and now here I will select here Windows 7 8.1 10 server setup. Okay, and after that you have to select your ISO file. In my case, it is J drive, under J drive. So I will click over there, and now go to under your J drive, and I will go under J drive because I have already created this blank partition over there. So and select this ISO file, okay. After that click on this OK button. So now you have to enter the name, like in my case I am putting here Windows 10 network installation. Okay, after that click on OK. So it will take some time. So after done, you will get this message like this, done, happy booting. So click on OK. Now close all those things and open the AIO creator. And after that, click on yes. Now you'll get this window. So you have to click, now this time you have to click on this run PXE. And you can see all your details over there. So now I'm going to show you on my virtual machine, it's working or not. So I forget one more setting, which is you have to go to your my computer, and right click on your volume and go to the properties, and now click on sharing, and here you will get a network and sharing center. So click over there. Also, you can go through your control panel. Just go to the start menu and type over there control panel and open the control panel, and after that select here view by. You need to select your category, and now select this option which is network and internet, and now click on network and sharing center, and after that click on change advanced sharing setting from the left side, and you will get the same window. So now what you have to do, you need to enable this turn on network discovery, and after that you have to click on this all network, and here you need to give the public access, public folder access sharing, and after that you have to click on save changes. Now click on OK. After that done. So now first of all I will show you on my virtual machine. In this case I will use here a VMware. As you can see, here is a VMware. So I will click on home and create a new virtual machine. So click on create a new virtual machine. After that select here custom. Now click on next, then next, and I will select here, I will install the operating system later. Now click on next, and from here you have to select here Microsoft Windows, and I will choose here Windows 10 64-bit, as you can see. Now click on next, and I will select the location. Okay, so I will select your virtual machine, C drive, virtual machine, under virtual machine, and click on next, then next, then click on next, and click on finish. Now you have to click on edit virtual machine setting, and here you need to select network adapter and select your bridge connection. Okay, otherwise it will not connect. Okay, so you have to select your bridge connection and click on OK. Now let me show you guys. I'm going to start this virtual machine. So now let's see it's working or not. So as you can see, it is receiving the MAC address. So now after done, you will get a window like this. So you have to select here the first option which is WinP and setup, and click on enter. Now you have to select the Windows 10 network installation, which I have already said the name for when I was installed that Aio Boot. Okay, so now you have to select here Windows 10 network installation and click on enter. So after that you will get a network path like this. So I have already saved a network path, as you can see. So if you don't know your network path, just go to your shared drive and just right click on your volume and go to the properties, and if you'll click on sharing, and you will get your network sharing path. So you have to copy paste this network sharing path over there. So I'll type one by one / desktop minus 0PG 0NLA /J. So you have to put the same thing over there. Okay, you can copy paste using your notepad. Just go to the search menu. So here is a network shared path. After that you have to click on next over there. And now as you can see, I have to put the username, which is in my case it is technology. So I'm going to show you. So go to your main computer from where you have started your server, this Aio Boot Creator. So if you don't know your username, then just go to your start menu and go to this option and click on change account setting, and you will get your username. Now what you have to do, you need to go to the open your CMD, just go to your start menu and type over there CMD and open the command prompt and type over there net user, and you will get this your all the username over there. In this case it is technology, so I will put here the T is capital and technology, as you can see. So press enter. Now you have to put your computer password. In my case it is password, and after that press enter. So you will not see anything over there. You have to press enter, and after that it will run on your virtual machine properly. So as you can see, I'm going to install this OS. So installation is started, as you can see. So now I'm going to show you guys from two systems. Here is my laptop, as you can see, and here is my PC. So I have already configured that setting on my laptop, as you can see. So now, as you can see, my laptop is connected through patch cable on my router. Here's my router, and this PC also connected through patch cable. Okay, so now I'm going to show you guys how to do it if you are in LAN. So now what I have to do, I need to go to my BIOS menu. So I have to go enter setup, this one, and click on enter. So here is my BIOS menu. So I am using Gigabyte motherboard. So the setting is a little bit different. So if you are using Gigabyte motherboard, then the setting is almost same for you. So if you are using any other motherboard, then you have to go to your BIOS menu and enable the network boot. And after that, you have to boot from your network. Okay. So in my case, I'll go to the BIOS here. And after that, here I have to enable CSM support. I have to enable this feature, okay, and also under CSM support you will get like LAN PXE boot option ROM. So you have to enable this feature, okay. So it is already enabled, as you can see. So now press the F10 key from your keyboard, just press F10 key, and you will get this menu. And after that you have to select yes. And after that, I will press here F12 key to go to my boot menu. So here is my boot menu, as you can see. So in my case, IBSCL slot, which is my network LAN card, and this one is my pen drive. So now I have to select here IBSCL slot, okay, which is my network LAN card. So let's see. So now, as you can see, it's showing DHCP, which is dynamic host control protocol. That means it's connecting through your network. So now you will get this menu, same window as you can see. So I have to choose a WinP and setup, and after that select here Windows 10 network installation, the first option, and you will get the same option over there. So I hope this small video will really help for you, and please don't forget to click on the subscribe button, like button and share button. And if you have any queries or questions, then comments down below. I will see you guys on the next video. Take care.